Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophynut and welcome back to our Let's Replay series in Bioshock 2, where we try to delve a bit deeper into the story. We're still here in the final area of Siren Alley, the second area Siren Alley, near this crappy little sister orphanage sign. There's a few rooms we still need to check out down below, but I still want to check out my upgrades as well, because now we have 260 Adam again. Scout is interesting, but not really useful, so we're technically invisible for a while, as long as we activate that plasmid, but aside from being very stealthy, that's not really that interesting. Drill Lurker is pretty interesting. Electric Flash has kind of lost its luster, so we're just going to upgrade both Electrobolt and Incinerate, so that should do very nicely. So Chain Lightning.
Kill an enemy longer. Charge up to generate Chain Lightning.
So just realizing that you probably saw this already, but Incinerate you probably didn't see, so here we go, Incinerate 2. Set multiple foes on fire at once. Press and hold L2 to charge up an explosive firebomb.
Now you're cooking. Charge up for an explosive blast.
And as you can see, the fire actually spreads to multiple opponents as well. So 20 Adam left. Not really that interesting, but our plasmids have improved rather nicely. So that wounded Big Daddy is still walking around here as well. Heavy rivets. Thank you very much.
I'm game.
Okay, so that spider splicer is very interested in me.
I don't see you.
Well, the rivet gun kind of lost its luster. Especially considering what else we have. So the shotgun is way more powerful than that. So let's head into the, what's it called? The Green Groceries. Joe's Green Groceries. Let's take a look what we can find here. So the Vita Chamber is located in this area, it seems. There's a few dollars in there. So, and underneath the cash register, we have a conspicuous switch. You might remember that we found an audio diary in the casino, I think it was. Where there was some guy talking about a plasmid shipment that was hidden behind the counter. So let's check this switch out. Let's press it. And that opens up an area in the back. So we're gonna see that in a minute. Kinda got something in my throat at the moment. Kinda hurt. I don't think there's much else here aside from what, of course, is in the back. Right over here. Right there, that staircase opened up. Bolted meat and 50 caliber rounds. Don't know why there should be 50 caliber rounds right next to the food, but never you mind. More food, and then of course this lovely area. This guy.
Turn the fuck around! I'm warning you!
Okay, so let's research that thing. Target was mostly out of frame.
Fucking up our business!
Fucking up our business. Let's hack this thing. And there we go. And I'm gonna have to be careful because there seems to be a splicer over there. And there we go. Spear in his ass. That also gives us another. Oh, do. We are friendly. So let's just do that again and hack the security camera. And there we go. A B for some reason, because I can't keep hacking those. I should be destroying them to get more research scores. So that's rather sadly, but hey, let's go on with the research camera just in case there's anything else around here. There was a dead splicer over there, so we could drop down. We're first going to check out this place, because I think, if I'm not mistaken, there should be something here. Hello? Oh yeah, so there's another switch, but I think, god damn it, can I push the button? I think this just disables the security because we missed one of those in one of the previous rooms in the Pink Pearl as well, because there was another button that you could use to turn down the security, but since we hacked everything, There's nothing for us to do with that. Let's pick up this first aid kit. Is there no audio diary in this place? I thought there was. Never mind then. I take that back. Maybe the guy that jumped out had that. Let's jump down and check out the corpse of this lovely man over here. Nothing yet. And it's pretty dark around here as well, because I'm not seeing much. More Dr. Holcroft stuff. And that's pretty much it. Can we open? Ooh, never mind. Never mind. I wonder if I ever found this, because I'm not really sure if I did in my previous playthroughs. What is this place? So we know they tried to make plasmids in here. But this is rather ominous. Such a dark area. Is there another spot? Oh, there's an audio diary. An empty niche.
This lamb twist went after Ryan all cockeyed. Solidarity angle was smart at first. Poor houses and bread lines. High grade bunko. And that religious rights debate? Gotta wonder if she staged it just to watch Ryan squirm up there in his monkey suit. Lamb's only problem is she really buys into the whole song and dance. Saving the world? Ha! Rapture just ain't her town. Ryan's got her on ice somewhere now. And I figured that opens up the charity scam for the professionals.
So there we go. Now we know where Fontaine got his idea for the orphanages. And of course the poorhouses, because he used that in Bioshock 1 to gain control of pretty much everybody. So there was a spider splicer waiting under the water here, but I kind of headshotted him with a spear. Killed him instantly, and there's another, I think it's a tonic, it's kind of big to be a tonic, but... Cure All, use Rapture's plentiful medical services to full advantage. With Cure All, you'll be in tip-top shape whenever you visit a health station. So health stations also refill your Eve. Not that interesting for now, so let's just keep that over there. I can't pick up any more of the heavy rivets. And something triggered the camera, so probably someone that entered the building. The hidden compartment. Okay, kind of missed my spear there. How much is there? So the turret is for some reason firing at the other thing. So look at you, hacker. Another trophy for... Okay. Oh, for fuck's sake. You couldn't even see me. But never mind. He got deaded. So that's this little area in the groceries, the green groceries. We do want to keep the shotgun handy just in case. It's a bit more versatile than the spear gun. Any more splicers? Because they keep respawning. I hear one. Let's check out this first. Could we buy anything else? No, I think we're pretty full up on everything. Don't get any extra Adam. So next up, the orphanage. Damn, I'm losing my voice. The orphanage, so the little sister's orphanage. Always a very interesting area to visit, especially if there's machine gun bullets on the counter for some reason. There's little girls in here. Be careful. Anything around here? Nope. Anything under the counter? No, we could search the desk, but something else then. Ooh, what was that? File cabinet. Search. Shotgun bullets. Yes, because that's also very, very safe near children. Shotgun ammo. Because even if they didn't... What the hell happened? Okay. One of the splicers probably passed alongside the camera. Okay. Hi there. Okay then. See you later, I suppose. Was that supposed to be scary? Because that wasn't that in the slightest. We just smash this. There we go. Because we got a 50% increase in our drill damage right now, because we investigated the big daddies like that. More shotgun ammo. Might come in handy actually against that spider splicer. A lot of room seems to be shattered, and of course a lot of paintings, well, drawings from the little sisters running around in here. Okay, so this is all closed off. How do we continue then? Probably through this door. This is a rather large area, because I don't remember everything as well as I did from Bioshock 1. A lot of Eve hypos, also very fitting. And in the back, of course, Eleanor. So this is the next stop of where Eleanor was placed after she was abducted by, well, by someone from Grace Holloway and placed in the orphanage. So let's listen to what she has to say. My name is Eleanor.
I'm all alone here, Mr. Diary. You're my whispering friend. A doctor keeps coming to see me. He says Rapture needs me, and tomorrow I'll be leaving with him. I ask why, and he just smiles. I'm not an orphan. Mom's alive somewhere, and Aunt Gracie is still probably looking for me. But I can't wait for them. I'm going to escape and find Amir, and we'll steal a submarine. Before it's tomorrow, I'll know what sunshine feels like.
So Eleanor also wants to escape, but of course she was trapped here at that time. And she wanted to elope with Amir, her friend, her dog-eater friend, as she calls them. And now, of course, I think we should get ambushed by that spider spicer, because we didn't manage to kill the man. There we go, there goes the light. Could he drop down behind us? Apparently he couldn't. Can we open this one? Yeah? Okay, that seems like, wait, was that corpse there? Don't remember that corpse being there. I know it's very fitting with the needles and everything, but hello? This is awfully quiet, so that opened up now. And a teddy bear dropped down. This is actually really cool. Done. I'm actually wondering, just for myself, how far I investigated everything in my original playthroughs, because I haven't been that thorough, apparently, as I did with the first game. Okay. So he's closed that off again. Goodbye, so let's search you from behind the grate. So that's one, but we know there's two. And there's a brute splicer. And then a few heavy rivets. Didn't we shotgun you? And drill his life away! Ow. There we go, in the face. So that was a brute splicer. Still didn't fully research these guys, apparently. And I still think there was another... Because one of those spider splicers had a mask, and I don't think we found one with a mask already. But never mind. Because we couldn't open that other area, so that's pretty much it, I think. How fast do you see me? Okay, he's jumping around like a madman. Is he? Okay, he's over there. Oh, that was on the face. But you only have close quarters attacks. Well, aside from that, was that another? I heard another brute splicer. Yep, there we go.
fairy. All you.
Hello. And that's that, and then some anti-personnel rounds to the face. Maybe shocking him even. Do that. Shocking him again, and hitting him again. A plus indeed. Thank you very much. And our trap rivets are almost full, I think. Should we? Yeah, we should heal up and get that heart. And then, of course, what we're all been waiting for. Let's go into the Temple of the Lamb. Seems to be... No, that's the camera up there. So that's not much. There seems to be in a sort of machine room. So the pumping station is over there. And that's what he turned into a temple. Out of all the areas around here, he turned that into a temple. And there seem to be items over there as well, but that will be for later on. Drill fuel, let's just do that and take all the supplies in here, because that will be able to use that. And that seems to be broken as well. So let's head into the pumping station and confront Mr. Wales. Rocket spear, that is very interesting. So rocket spears attach to targets and repels them with great force before exploding. So that's also very, very cool. There's a few more here. Because those are very, very valuable. This is also a very nice way to show off the fireball. Hi! Oosh! So there we go. The firebomb just took out 4 splicers, I think. That was a very nice way to demonstrate that thingy. Thank you. Thank you very... No, God damn it. I'm looking for... Yeah, this one. Nope, okay, dollars. Dollar bills. Guidance of Lamb.
Admiral Ryan left us wandering, confused and alone amongst yesterday's wreckage. But Sophia Lamb shows us that we are not alone. We are together as a family. So when you see a man brought to his knees, recognize that he is your brother and pull him up. Sophia Lamb teaches us what is in common is good. What is irreducible is right. She guides us all to the indivisible along a river of Adam. Rapture's daughter, Eleanor, shall be our vessel. In her, we shall be reborn.
So there we go, confirming that everybody should die and all the Adam should be put into Eleanor. And in Eleanor, we will be reborn. That is... some sick way of going around it, doesn't it, isn't it? So, more shotgun shells. Is there anything interesting in there? Maybe a bit more drill fuel. Just to prepare a bit, so we are never alone, indeed. Because, of course, of the family. Spear ammo, by which we are saved. So that explains this as well. So, by which we are saved. So, when the little sister extracts Adam from your corpse, you shall be saved because you're put into the giant big pool of Adam. Along all the other sore saps that believed all this bullshit. But that is... Okay, I wanted to research, but that didn't really work. And I think that's it for this area. I could go upstairs as well. Maybe that's a better idea, because I think we get a nice overview shot if we go upstairs. Never mind. I'm wrong. As usual, I'm wrong. There seems to be a few... Ooh. Ooh, did I ever find this? Mini turrets? We have mini turrets by the dozens. So let's just hack the door. There we go. Pretty hard door, actually, as doors go. There we go. Secure door is now unlocked. And what is this? Seems to be... Would this be Simon Wales' office? Actually, never checked that out. Auto hack dart. There we go. Heavy rivets, strap rivets, and bandages. That could have been better, actually. Shackled to the great chain. And what is this? So yeah, the DNA strand stands for the genetics and the butterflies, of course. Also, the genes are freed into the clouds, into butterflies, when you are put into Eleanor's body. Which sounds creepier every time I say it. So, let's listen to The Shackles.
Until Adam, the human animal was a slave to the gene, the inner tyrant. Lust, greed, rage, self-obsession was etched into our DNA. We were not pulling the great chain of progress, as Ryan believed, but shackled to it. But now, in theory, we can redraft the human blueprint. Serving the common interest can become as natural as breathing. The tyrant will simply go extinct.
And this is, in my mind, the biggest advantage that... advantage. Depends on how you view it. The advantage that Lam has. As we heard Fontaine say that she was pretty smart in going for the charity angle, and that he took that as his own. But I'm not sure that he was right, because... Sophia Lam actually believes what she is proclaiming. She is not a swindler. She's not a con man as Fontaine was. She believes everything, every word she says. She wants to save everybody by letting them die and putting them in Eleanor. So another crucifixion here. Let's take that, nothing in particular. And then of course another painting. A painting that should be very familiar if you've watched or played Bioshock 1. This is of course the moment we inject ourselves with Electrobolt, our first plasmids in the game. So the hands of Jack Ryan confirmed with those chains around his wrists. And there we go, let's head into
the beast is upon us, children. It wears a hide of iron, and its hands are death and change. It would seize the child from us, and with her, paradise itself! Be ye soldier of the ground, or angel of the sky, ye must stand fast and send it howling back to hell!
And send it howling back to hell. I know that's a reference to something. Send them screaming back to hell, send them howling back to hell. I think that's also another line from Moby Dick, if I'm not mistaken. So Captain Abar, that was the captain name I was looking for in the previous episodes. So that's another reference to the whales, and he also talks a bit captain-like, if I can be that cliche. So let's auto-hack the save, and let's check that out. 3 remote hack darts and rocket spears. Yeah, thank you very much, and we're actually full on rocket spears already. So we're gonna be using those, of course. And then, of course, the most important thing in this room, the power to the people station. Let's check that out. I'm really, really itching to get the rivet gun heat upgrade, but I think, because we do need to get the rivet gun clip size before that. So I'm gonna go with that, and then next up, we're gonna go with the heat upgrade, because since we're running with the Inferno, the human Inferno tonic, we should be upgrading our rivet gun to exert fire damage. Therapy with grace number 2. So we found the first one at Pauper's Drop, I think. So let's take a listen.
All right, Doctor. I'm here. But don't think wearing this butterfly means I'm happy.
Grace, I know you all too well. Want of child defines you. But biological loyalty turns us against the rest of the world, whom we ought to love in equal measure. Your poverty is testament to that, but your voice inspires the people. I am asking you to join a much larger family. Though your body failed you, you shall live on in us.
So, it's not that because I said that Sophia Lam believes every word she says, that she's not extremely manipulative. Because of course she is. She gathers people by lying to them. And there we go. Right into a boss battle. There we go. Okay. Let's take care of that guy with Phosphorus Buck, and he should die immediately. And then let's take a jump down and let's see what we can do. So he's still burning. And now we have our shotgun, because we need to be careful, because Simon Wales is a spider splicer as well. Okay. And I think I hear... Okay, so that's the... There we go. As long as we fire headshots, that should be fine. Where did that come from? There we go. There is a vending machine in the back, so that should be fine. Let's research this guy. Okay, that was the wrong one. Okay, thank you very much. You need to be careful. Let's go with the rocket spears and take them for a spin. Because the last one in here will be Simon Wales himself. There we go, one in the face. Let's just fire them in his body. I don't think we can research him. No, we cannot, but we can research these things. Hello, Simon Wales. This guy is a really tough bastard, so let's quickly buy some health kits in between here. Let's give him another rocket. And there we go, so they're getting propelled around like ragdolls. Oh, where did that grenade go? Let's drill him, because he's a really, really powerful spider splicer. God damn it. Where did he go? Where is he going? You need to be careful. Don't want to die now. Where the hell did I come from? I'm not seeing him anymore. Hello. Well, now that we're doing that, just quickly gonna hack this thing then. Hack. So I hear him, but I'm not really sure where. Oh, hi. Where is he? There he is. And down he goes. Defeated the preacher.
Control, Otto. Be in the back. One thing though. Once you transfer the suction to Dionysus Park, we've got a tiny window of opportunity to get you inside. I don't have much air left, but I'll hang in there. You make sure you're ready before you throw that switch.
So with making sure we're ready, it actually means finish every business you have in this area. Because once we flip that switch, everything is gonna go to hell. Very, very fun. But first, the Creed of the Faithful.
We believe in the Daughter of the Lamb, hallowed Savior and anointed vessel, whose blood with our blood, sin with our sin, mind with our minds, life with our life, lifts us up from the depths, transcends base temptation, and delivers us all from ego. We commend ourselves to the new and unknown, born by our common strength and guided by the Lamb.
Guided by the Lamb. But that didn't work out so well, now did it? I think I've done everything I could in Siren Alley. We've been here for quite some time. I also don't think there are any new paintings around here. There are a few around here, but I don't think they bring us anything new. Except, of course, for this one. So that's all the little sisters worshipping Eleanor herself. Because Eleanor is a bit older, of course. So she should be a big sister by now. But that's... Well, yeah, the worship of Eleanor. Kind of creepy, but I think so that's the one with the little sister. There's a room over there, though, isn't it? Or maybe that's just the staircase, probably is. Yeah, that's just the staircase. So I think we're done for this area. So this one we've seen. Then the one with the little sister, the airplane. And the one with Dr. Steinman is probably not even here. So that's it for this area. Okay, here we go to the pumping station. And let's drain the water away from this place. Away from Dionysus Park and then giving Sinclair a bit of air. Is there anything in this room? Because there keep being rooms in places that I don't actually suspect them. There went my voice again. I'm sorry. Kind of running at the end of two recording sessions, and that's why my voice is going away a bit. But right now, let's switch it up. Pump control, Dionysus Park, here we go.
Delta, vying for control of a dead man's dream. The city is nothing. Rapture must die so that Eleanor may rise from its body. Allow me to demonstrate.
And here we go.
Lambs overloading the pumps. The place is coming down. Get to Dionysus Park.
So Sophia Lamb overloads the place, overloads the pumps, flooding Siren Alley along with every living being inside of it. So this guy, yeah, let's put him out of his misery. You don't want to, yeah, you don't want to die just about, well, for Lamb's craziness. So yeah, this is what Lamb's plan is, killing everybody.
Subject Delta, I want you to commit this moment to memory for me. This howling, brutish slog through the dark. This is who we are.
So killing everybody, turning them into atom factories for the little sister to scrounge afterwards, and then combining that all into a single creature that will be Eleanor. So let's head back upstairs, because that's where we need to go. We need to go back to outside. Well, outside, okay. Hello there. Search again, nothing, okay. There's another first aid kit over here, and let's take this outside, because we need to run. Everything is going to shit. Let's ignore the enemies behind us, because I hear a spider splice running across the... Okay, that's not good. And there we go. Silence. Complete and utter silence. Because, she just killed everybody in Siren Alley. Not that we didn't do the same thing, but everybody who was still alive
Look,
is
Delta,
now dead.
It is the world for which you strive. You. Alone among the dead.
Yeah, because you killed everybody. That's not something I strive towards. You are the reason that everybody's dead. Not anything else. We can't even use the vending machines anymore because, well, they're kind of wet. It's not good, is it? And there's a corpse right here as well. Thank you for your canned beans. And let's get outside. There's been no need to go to the airlock anymore. There we have Big Sister again, if you can see her over there. In the window, waiting for us, not sure what's happening. Is there still water in there, actually? Because she's running, so that kind of means that we succeeded in our task of clearing out everything over here. So let's head into Dionysus Park, which is... another very, very interesting area. Let's swap this around. Drain. And into a loading screen, if I'm not mistaken. Get the Dionysus Park completed. And here we are.
Dionysus Park was owned by Sophia Lamb, Chief. Sort of a private retreat for her social experiments. One night it flooded, killing all her guests. Paper said it was cult-related. Come on up to the train station. Let's rendezvous.
Cult-related would imply that Sophia did it herself to fuel her family cult and adding to the atom pile of the place. And since she owned it, that would not be such a strange assumption. But of course, we can't jump to conclusions until we investigate a bit further. But before we head any further into Dionysus Park, this... place that was flooded for years and years, giving it a very unique style. We're gonna take a little break. So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I'd really, really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye.